love to talk a little bit about using the coolest little graph thing ever. It's called an analemma. And it's really fun to say. Let's all say it together. Analemma. 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 Okay, maybe you're not as excited. Let's talk first about what it's doing for us. Basically, if we remember, we've got our solar energy, and the solar energy is coming from the sun, and the sun is very, very large. And here's our little Earth, and we're spinning here, and everything is happy-go-lucky. Well, sometimes I'm remembering that we tilt, and so we travel around the sun as we're doing that. And so sometimes in our whole revolution, that whole trip that we make all the way around the sun, sometimes that light energy is going to be coming in, and it's striking right at the equator at 90 degrees, okay? And that's going to be what we call our equinox, right? Other times, right, with that tilt, other times it's going to be coming in and it's going to be striking at the Tropic of Cancer. And so that's 0 degrees and that's 23.5 degrees north. So with that tilt, right, of 23 and a half degrees, sometimes those sun's rays are going to be coming in. And that's going to be, for us, the June solstice or the summer solstice. Other times, right, whole revolution staying at the same tilt. Other times, it's going to be coming around and it's going to be hitting down here at 23.5 degrees south or the Tropic of Capricorn. And so it will be coming in, the sun's rays will be striking right there. Okay, at the Tropic of 23.5 degrees south. Okay, so I know, and this is going to be December 21st, and then December, January, February, March 21st-ish, it's going to be at the equator, then March, April, May, June, I think it's 22nd, 21st, something like that. It'll be up there at 23 and a half degrees north in June, July, August, September. It'll be right back here at the equator again, then September, October, November, December, right? Now, I've tilted this guy back and forth to show the relationship to the sun, but really it's just staying tilted and going around, right? So there's other videos that do a better job at showing that. Where, oh, where is the sun every other day, right? Well, I know that it touches here one time per year. I know it touches here one time per year, but when is it going to be at any of these others? I know that here it's going to be two times per year. Well, it's going to be everywhere, boom, boom, bouncing kind of back and forth twice every year. That is the great big idea behind the analemma. Okay, so the analemma goes through, and on the left side, on this axis, it goes through and it talks about our latitude. All right, so here's going to be the zero, or that will be the equator. When is the sun at the equator? Well, we know it's there once in September 23rd, and we know it's there on March 21st. What? Check that out. Along this loop, it goes through September 5th, 10th, 15th, 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd. Right in that area. Then we know that the sun's rays are going to be all the way down here at 23.5 degrees south in December, like December 21st. Check that out. Coming across, it's going to be right there. Perfect. Okay, and then January, February, March, we're back at the equator. And then March, April, May, June, it's going to be up here at 23.5 degrees north, once touches there and then comes back down. Now, the width of all of this equation of time, we're not going to worry about that, but that's what the analemma is. So let's say that on September 30th, we wanted to know where the sun angle was, or not necessarily the sun angle, but where, what latitude is the sun striking at, right? Well, that's cool. So August, September 30th is right there. I'm going to put my little straight edge there. It comes across and it looks like it is, if that's two, that's three, that's four, like 2.5 degrees south. Okay. So it's striking just past the equator, 2.5 degrees south on that particular day. Let's take another day. Let's take May 13th. Okay. So I'm going to come over here, September, October, November, December, January, March, April, May 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th. Wow. it looks like it's just about at 18 degrees north. Now, good to remember that these are all going to be in the northern hemisphere, and all of these guys are in the southern hemisphere. Okay, the other thing that we may want to do is kind of do this in reverse. So let's say that we're looking for a place that is at 10 degrees south, and we want to know when the sun is, what dates the sun is directly overhead. We can just put this guy at 10 degrees south, and then we go, hey, it intersects once right there, which looks like October 20th, and it's also going to be there in February 23rd, maybe. Okay. So February 23rd and October 20th, the sun is going to be directly overhead at 10 degrees south. Okay. 10 degrees south. Cool. So that's going to be what we do with the analemma and how that helps us. We can use it to figure out a latitude and when the sun is overhead, or we can go by date and figure out what the latitude of the sun will be for that particular spot.